and it is crunch time here on The Jump. Earlier, hoops, Martin Luther King Day. We got him all day. Andre Drummond switching out on Bradley Beal, and it does not go well.
Oh.
Wizards bench can't control themselves.
That's called taking advantage of the switch.
It's hard to stop a Mack truck from going downhill.
I mean, Andre needs some help there, right, Coach?
Yeah, I don't know if he should be out there.
That's a tough one. Ugh.
The bench is amazing.
Oh.
That's amazing. By the way, if they can get that kind of bench play next season when you get John Wall back, I'm just saying. I think it was
okay, Wizards supported.
I'm just saying they're fun. No defense, but they're fun. Marcus Smart hit 11 threes on Phoenix on the way to beating Phoenix on Saturday. He shot 50%, 22 attempts. Now, they did lose the game, but still, 11 threes.
He's fearless. He's fearless, and he worked on his three ball all summer. You can tell with the way he's letting it go. And he's just crazy enough to hit that.
You know, I would never thought we'd ever see this from Marcus Smart, but frankly, they need these baskets
yes.
right now. They're struggling. They need some shooting from their role players.
Yes. Yep. Well, the Celtics hosting the Lakers tonight. Good news for both teams on the injury front. Anthony Davis, Jaylen Brown, and Kemba Walker all making their returns tonight. So a good stock game. LeBron taking advantage of being in Massachusetts. Drove over to Springfield earlier today for his son's high school game at the Basketball Hall of Fame. LeBron will go head-to-head with Kemba Walker in Boston later tonight, and it has been a one-sided matchup. LeBron, guys, is 28-0 all-time versus Kemba. That includes a four-game playoff sweep in 2014.
You were there for that?
I was there
for
that.
I, too, was there. I was the sideline reporter for you guys for that one, and it wasn't. It could have been a three-game sweep. It was not close. 28-0, though. Usually, like, something happens in some game where you can get a game in there.
Kemba hasn't paid one of his goons to take him out yet. You gotta get LeBron out of the game. That's what you got.
The Hornets did actually beat the Cavs once while LeBron was in Cleveland, but Kemba was out that game. So this
doesn't count.
Yeah, so this doesn't really reflect on Kemba as much as it reflects on the greatness of the Heat and the Cavs and the difficulty of his years in Charlotte. But Kemba's coming off of a sore knee. I guarantee. And the Celtics need a big win. I guarantee he's going to bring everything he can tonight because he never wants to hear this stat again.
Yeah. No, he doesn't. He's a big-time player.
I do want to skip over to our LeagueCast game of the night, Thunder at Rockets. This is going to be their third regular season matchup. Now, OKC and Houston split the first two. They're only three games apart in the standings. Fizz, did you imagine we would be saying that coming into the season?
I tell you what, you got to give Billy Donovan and those guys a ton of credit for what they've done. Sam Presti, to me right now, is executive of the year for what he pulled off in the offseason, and to have this team competing for playoffs, it's really awesome to see. And I think Chris Paul has actually found a home that he feels really good about. He's got two young guards that he can mentor now, and they're playing great basketball.
You know what? I think if both teams had the option to undo the deal right now, they wouldn't. I think both teams are kind of actually happy with where they are. A year from now, let's see where it is.
I don't know, man. I am really interested. There was a lot of buzz the last time these teams played. I expect it again today. Thanks to these guys for joining me. Jump is back tomorrow. See you then.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports analysis and highlights, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.